Welcome to clickmyproject.com. The title of the project is Multitask Weekly Supervised Attention Network for Dementia Status Estimation with Structural MRI. And the abstract of the project is Alzheimer's disease is a permanent and dynamic psych disease that consistently affects memory force and thinking capacity aptitudes that it impacts the ordinary everyday practice of person. Structural imaging based on magnetic resonance is an integral part of the clinic assessment of patients with suspected Alzheimer's dementia. Prospective data on the natural history of change in structural markers from preclinical to overt stages of Alzheimer's disease are radically changing how the disease is conceptualized and will influence its future diagnosis and treatment. Atrophy of medicine temporal structural structures is now considered to be a valid diagnostic marker at the mild cognitive impairment stage. Structural imaging is also included in diagnostic criteria for the most prevalent non-Alzheimer dementias, reflecting its value in differential diagnosis. In this, we propose a deep learning classification model to recognize the Alzheimer's disease. The convolutional neural network algorithm is implemented and classifies the type of Alzheimer's disease from the structural MRI grayscale images and find the result in terms of accuracy. And the flow diagram of the project is, first we need to start the program and select the different types of Alzheimer's disease structural MRI dataset, and it will appear into data preprocessing. In data preprocessing, we are going to visualize the sample images. After visualization, we are going to resize all the images into similar size and convert it into array. Then it will appear into model selection. In model selection, we are going to split our dataset into training dataset and testing dataset. After that, it will process it into classification method. In classification, we are using deep learning algorithm, a convolutional neural network algorithm. By applying the convolutional neural network algorithm, classification of normal classes, Alzheimer's disease, mild cognitive impairment, stable mild cognitive impairment, patient with mild cognitive impairment. These are all the disease type of Alzheimer that was extracted from the structural MRI grayscale images. And finally, estimate the performance based on the matrices like accuracy, precision, recall and FN score. The program was successfully executed in Anaconda Navigator Spider IDE. So these are all the first module, data selection and loading module. In that, I have to visualize the sample images like Alzheimer's disease class, normal class, unstable mild cognitive impairment class, and patient with mild cognitive impairment class, and finally this is the mild cognitive impairment class. So these are all the classes that we are going to classify by using our neural network algorithm. So after that, after data selection and loading, it will apply into data preprocessing. In data preprocessing, I am going to check the minimum height and maximum height, minimum width and maximum width for every images. After checking these images, I am going to resize the images into similar shapes like 65, 65. That means height is 65 and also width is 65. After resizing, I am going to visualize all the classes that like a sample images in our console working directory. Then I am going to choose the independent variable and dependent variable. After selecting the independent and dependent variable, I am going to split our data set into training data set and testing data set. So this is independent variable train data and this is the independent variable test data, and this is the dependent variable train data and this is dependent variable test data. So after splitting, I am going to apply these inputs into our convolutional neural network algorithm. So these are all the summary result of convolutional neural network algorithm. So the convolutional neural network algorithms that constructed based on the convolution layer, max pooling layer, dropout layer, flattened layer and dense layer. So these are all the layers which is used to extract the trainable parameters by using our input images. So the convolutional neural network algorithm which extract the overall parameter is 926,917. So those parameters are in the trainable form. So our algorithm will go into train the images based on the parameters for 15 different training epochs. So these are all the result of our training results. So this is the loss and accuracy for the every epoch. So after that, we are going to visualize the performance in the graphical representation. So this is the accuracy plot and this is the loss. Accuracy will gradually increase and loss is gradually decreases. So the evolution of our convolutional neural network algorithm is 99%. So this is the accuracy of our convolutional neural network algorithm. After that, we are going to find the classification report and confusion matrix. So in classification report, we are going to find the precision recall F1 score value for all the classes. So precision means number of correct prediction and recall means number of correct instance of prediction and F1 score means to measure the test accuracy. So this is the confusion matrix diagram. The confusion matrix diagram, confusion matrix result, and this is the confusion matrix diagram. So the confusion matrix diagram, which is going to explain the number of correct prediction and number of misclassification that contains from the every classes by using our convolutional neural network algorithm. So the finally the user will manually choose the images from our dataset directly, and our algorithm will going to predict the exact class of the input images. So the predicted input image is normal class. So these are all the variables that we are used in our program.